Hey, you're watching Raw Power with Angelo from Fishbone. They're fixing the funky, but can be a freaking frantic fantango, feeling froth falling from my mouth, fantasizing about free-minded feces getting freaky with the nearby fishbone that frolic within the fishbone pine. Can you dig it?
Fight the Youth, you know, it basically deals with a very poor subject that's still around with us today, racism. And it's like, you know, racism being taught to young people. Sometimes they don't learn it in the home. Sometimes they learn it out in the streets. I want to be cool, man. I want to hang out with these skinheads, man. But my dad's a liberal or whatever. Forget that. I'm gonna be racist just because it's fashionable. Mm-hmm. And that's what
just
it's
because
about.
I want to be a part of some type of group, and I don't want to be alone or individual. People who are affected by the disease of racism are usually ignorant and chalked with fear.
Yeah, but then there's a whole new crop of people.
Crap, yes.
Crap of people that know better and still roll with that program. And it's basically directed towards them. Shape up or ship out. The one good thing about the riots is that everybody didn't know what was going to happen to them. And that's how black people live every day. They live in fear of the people that are supposed to protect them. We all can't sit around blissed out like Fat Boy and PM Dawn, you know?
See, man, it's a lot of hard-headed people in this world today. It's more hard-headed people than there are sensible people, you know? You cannot crack this cement with this shoe. You need a jackhammer. Some people's heads and minds and wills are like the cement right here. It's hard.
And people try and pretend like it doesn't exist or just a part of the problem just as well. Nobody says you have to speak up and be counted, but don't sit up and ignore it when it's right there in your face, you know? That pisses me off.
What happened? A couple days after the riot, everybody was trying to act like everything was okay.
It ain't okay.
And it wasn't. On tour here in the USA a couple of times, we had the Fishbone Big Bodacious Booty Contest, where we have contestants.
Tour to sex is fun.
Yeah.
We have to do it every now and then.
Yeah, we got to do it every now and then, right? And so, like, we have a dance contest, right? And whoever wants to join it, whoever thinks that they can shake their booty the best to Fishbone music, they come up on stage. The first contestant, they come out and they shake their booty. And then they go off. Next one comes up. They shake their booty, and whoever can shake their booty the best gets a Fishbone t-shirt or a Fishbone hat. Well, we had these two girls come on the bus after the show, and they said, we didn't like your Fishbone booty contest. We thought you were degrading women. We didn't really like it, and we were going to tell everybody not to buy your Fishbone records anymore, you know? And I said, well, you know, I think you should ask the women to join the contest. Because from the looks of it, it looks like they were having a real good time, and they didn't feel degraded in any way.
There's a fine line between sexuality and sexism, and sometimes people don't know where that line is drawn. And, you know, to me, I might do things that are considered sexist, but it's not as a means to degrade women or make them into some subservient role of what I perceive them. You know, I like women, you know, I like career women, you know, mm-hmm. myself. You know, women in tight business suits, going in there, closing deals, making mergers. You know,
no, that makes
powerful
me...
women.
Yes!
Women that are on equal footing with me.
See, it's
that now... I respect them for what they do and their body. That's what I want. I want a woman for her mind and her body.
Yeah, you don't want no stupid hoe. You want a smart woman.
Word.
Nowadays, it's too much. They still consider women the minority, man.
Yeah.
They consider women the minority.
John Lennon said it. Woman is the nigger of the world.
Nigger of the world. See, but yet, the woman is the physical creator of man. She has all the babies. She gives all the love. You know? I got arrested for indecent exposure at this concert in, where was that again?
Amherst, Massachusetts.
And they wanted to take me to court on it, you know? But just think about it, right? These clothes, these pieces of material here, okay? They're only forms of shame when you really think about it, okay? And because we got this law saying that you gotta wear clothes and you gotta hide your body, people are ashamed of their real beautiful self. Now, I know this is like a really ridiculous thing, you know, like, well, hey, everybody run around with no clothes on. But at least if everybody had the naked attitude and state of mind, and the whole world would be a better place if they weren't trying to hide all the time.